lately I've been noticing Facebook page cover shots, the headers, which is the image that you're seeing here, sized in a way where things are getting cut off and the image probably isn't exactly the way the person wants it to be. And so I wanted to show you a quick way to adjust the size of this picture, both on your Facebook pages for your businesses and on profiles for your personal use. Now for Facebook pages, I use a program called Canva.com. It has a free version, and they have all of these really great pre-sized templates. So I'm going to choose the Facebook cover, and you can choose one of the templates they have here on the left. Everything will be sized perfectly for that Facebook image. So you could put something, you know, if you were doing a party or a page for, maybe, I don't know what this would be, maybe an apple orchard or something. All you have to do is drag that over and then edit it. You can edit the font, you can edit the picture, you can play around with it. It's very easy to use. So, but we're going to not do that. I'm going to show you how to use your own images to create your Facebook cover. Over on the left, you'll see uploads. And here you can upload any of your own images and use them, and they will automatically size the way you need them to. Now, if you look at this picture is very large, and it's not the rectangle that you see on this image. This rectangle here, it's not sized the same. But if you drag it over until you see the blue lines around it and drop it, that picture has now been cropped to be perfect for your Facebook page. Great, Tracy, you're saying, but that is not the way I want the image to look. Okay, gotcha. So you can do a couple of things. We're gonna go to crop here and you see the full image. You can drag this wherever you want it to be. You can even make the background image bigger if you want to, so that you can crop it a little differently. I'm going to leave it the width that it already is. And we're going to set the top line at the top of the coffee cup here. And the bottom crop is going to be at the bottom of this plate. And the left side will be right at her arm, so that you can see how this gives you something to pay attention to when we look at it on the Facebook page. So I'm going to say done. And then we're going to call it Lady with Coffee Cup. I'm just going to say Lady with Coffee. And then here we'll download it as a JPEG. I do JPEGs because they take up, they're smaller files, and so they are easier to work with. And then we're gonna put it in our social media file here, Lady with Coffee. And then I'm gonna go back over to my page, and I'm going to change my cover, upload a new photo, and I'm gonna type in Lady with Coffee. And here it is. And you will see it cuts off at the top of the cup here, the left part of her arm here, or I guess that might be the right, her right arm, and the bottom of the plate right there. And it's perfect, so we're gonna hit save. And there you go, and now you have a new cover. Now, back on Canva, if you wanted to, you could put words over here pretty easily. You would just go over to this text area, and you could add different phrases here by, you can drag that over, and you can change what it says, and then you can change the font and the font size and the color. You can do all kinds of things right here. Or you can leave it without any text. And leaving it without text is the preferred method for Facebook headers on your business page especially. So I'm just going to leave it plain like that. And there you go. That's what it looks like on Facebook. Now let's look at the personal profile. This is where I really see a lot of problems, is I'll be looking at someone's personal profile, and instead of the image looking like this, the image looks like this. Now, theoretically, if you're going to put a picture on your Facebook cover here and you have people in it, you like those people and you maybe even want to highlight a special event that that person was in, or maybe it's even you. Why would you cut their heads off like that? All we can see is the dogs behind her here. So we're going to update the cover photo, reposition it, and drag it down, and we can crop it however we want. I could put the people way down at the bottom if I wanted to. So That is how you reposition a photo on your Facebook profile. Don't cut your friends' heads off. Don't cut your kids' heads off. And don't cut your own head off. It's a pretty easy fix. It takes just a few seconds. And if your photo really isn't sized properly to do this, try putting it over in canva.com and resizing it there and see if that helps. Bye-bye.
I hope you found value in this week's tech tip. Make sure to subscribe here on YouTube. And if you have any questions or you would like to see a tech tip in the future about a specific topic, please be sure to go to Tracy@launchtechmadeeasy.com and let me know, or pop a comment in below the video here and let me know what your question is, and I'll be sure to answer it on a future episode. Bye-bye.